I like to say when I come to work, I see a miracle every day. Our new Veterinary Medical Center is really a transformational project. It's designed to really change what we do on an everyday basis. It brings together multiple disciplines into a facility, into an environment that's creative, innovative, and really future-looking.
The construction of the new Vet Med Center is really exciting. What we find is that veterinary science, you know, as a field keeps progressing, it's also necessary for Davis to expand and keep providing the top quality care that it's known for. And the new Vet Med Center will help us do that. And it's not just more space that we're talking about, but we're talking about state-of-the-art technology and all the brightest minds in vet med under one roof.
We're producing instruments in our hospital that are looking at modern technology to do whole body scans for animals that have metastatic cancer. We're using linear accelerators to precisely eliminate that cancer. We're working with a comprehensive cancer center to take that technology and understand cancer in animals and in people as well. In addition, we're educating our veterinary students, our graduate students, our residents. With one of the largest residency programs in the country, we're training the next generation of specialists as well. And so this project really brings all that together into one environment that allows us to look at the future.
When I applied to UCDAVIS Veterinary Medicine, it was actually kind of a what-if school because I thought it would be incredible to come to the number one veterinary school in the country. So when I was accepted, it wasn't even really a question about if I was going to come here because I knew I was going to get a great education surrounded by the most motivated students and some of the best faculty in the world.
Our passion is to address societal need. It's part of our origins of the entire school. Part of that needs is to really feed the 9 billion people that will be on this planet in the year 2050. So we work closely with the College of Agriculture and Environmental Sciences to make that happen. And this facility, this big idea, will bring that latest technology to help in terms of making the food safe and secure.
The new Livestock and Field Services Center will allow us to update our facilities that we have here. So our first mission is to serve the agricultural community of California and help provide for food safety and food quality and our services to the agricultural community. Our second mission is to teach students, so to teach the future veterinarians, about food safety, about livestock diseases, and also just about medicine in general and surgery in general and how to be a good veterinarian. And then our third and one of our, our third mission is really to serve our clients and to provide excellent care and services to our animal owning clients.
Once you meet the faculty and the residents, you know how much everybody cares about what they're doing. I come here because this is truly a brain trust. You have great depth of knowledge in this place, and you never feel like you're on a 15-minute rotation of a vet facility. I never feel rushed here. I never feel that they don't care about what I have to say. They care about Daisy, and I think they also care about me.
Our Equine Performance Center, which is a main part of our first phase of this project, really brings cutting-edge research technology really into the arena. We're going to be able to put force plate analysis, videography, gait analysis that allows us to, in slow motion and with very accurate detail, determine lameness of horses. The small animal clinic is really bringing together what we know we do on an everyday basis, which brings the latest technology of over 30 specialties into really advancing the care of our patients. On the small animal side, what this facility will really transform is bringing that into a cohesive unit.
I always tell the students, the moment that an animal walks in the room, I'm looking at how they move, how they sit, how they get up, and then we do a really thorough physical exam, and I always say that I'm having a conversation with that animal. They have to talk to me, and I have to listen to them.
was actually given the opportunity to shadow some doctors in our intensive care unit here. And I spent a full day in the ICU helping triage and treat animals. And I'll never forget this one Labrador, and it's got a lot of fluid around its heart and it's having respiratory problems. And I was just astonished how fast like the faculty and the fourth year students like snapped into action. They knew exactly what they wanted to do and they delivered the best care possible to the animal, and it was with a great clinical outcome.
Donor support is absolutely essential, and at this time, particularly critical. We have strong support from this university, but we cannot go into the future without that donor support. We literally have programs that we would not be able to do without the care and the support, the passion, really, of our donors, which are partners with us. We need that support to be able to make the future happen.